Hi guys, it's Jill, and today I'm filming a barn vlog. What the heck? That's per crisis, isn't it? I'm putting my boots on real mild because I want to play with my pony a little bit, and I haven't done that in a fat minute because the weather has been trash and I've been busy and namely unmotivated. So, so popular. But yeah, I wanted to film a video today because I freaking feel like it, you know? I don't know when this is gonna get edited, or when I'm gonna decide to be responsible, but I do know that I felt like filming a video today, so that's what we are doing, and I'm going to get my pony out of her paddock yesture. She's right there, doing her zazzy things. I'm coming to get you. There's a kitty on my porch. First, I'm gonna get a little pouch of treats, and then I'm going to get her out and bring her to Zikrostas, and it's gonna be good family-friendly fun. So let's get rocking and rolling. Mama Amber's out there sleeping, snoozy bird. And there's the Zoe bird, beautiful and dirty, nasty nest. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you guys a bit about, you know, what I've been doing and what my plans are for the future. So if you don't listen to my podcast, which you 110% totally should, on like your drives to the barn when you're cleaning stalls, if you're out for a trail ride or some, just pop it in, listen to it. The last couple of episodes have been a little dark and centered around my experience con depression. All right, do you need something, Flit? There's Zazu, and her mommy is coming. I'll set you guys right here for the moment. Oh, Amber says, do not take baby, please. Anyways, guys, the podcast is pretty much where I've been detailing why I took such a long break from YouTube and social media and all of that. Is that right? Oh my goodness. But before I grab her, I do want to say that I am not going to be like riding or anything with her today. I want to be able to get her out and like do more things with her outside of just her paddock. But her and her mother are a little bit joined at the hip. He's my decrease that a little bit so that they both are like, oh, it's okay if we walk away. Zoe's pretty fine, but her mom's not that okay with it, and it gets Zoe a little revved. And smile. I hope she smiled just then. I can't see because there's a glare. I'm hoping to get her out and see some more relaxed behavior.
I see you. I'm gonna get you out.
But that's what we're working towards, because I would like to be able to get her out so that we can like do more things regularly. Also, I don't really know what happened, and I am terrified to speak too soon, but she's gotten so much more polite on the lead rope, because I haven't touched her in like 3 months. I don't know what happened or why we're like that, but like, she's just chilling. And 3 months is a bit of an exaggeration. I've been working with her here and there, but it's been like once every 2 weeks. Like, sad, sad, sad. But I talk about that more on the podcast, and there's no point in rambling here, because this is already a 4 minute clip. So, ooh, big pretty. Come on. Touch the air vent. Please don't scare yourself. She says, I am almost 9. Don't get scared anymore. Everybody over there is running. Come this way. As you all can see, we're still doing the positive reinforcement thing. Still working on that the best of our ability. I don't know, I am less concerned about being super rigid with it, which I know is probably my purist buddies are not going to be a super fan of that. I don't know, I kind of just want to enjoy my horse. I'm really tired of like just being like, I can't touch her without thinking about it so hard. We're gonna use as much positive reinforcement as possible. just so good. I don't know what happened. She just like grew up. I think it was really good for her, honestly, to just give her time to be a horse and not like be messing with her all the time. I don't know, I could just be over justifying, but she is a lot more relaxed, so whatever works, I guess. And also the reality of the situation is horses don't need us to like give them something to do with their lives. Most of them are perfectly content just chilling in a pasture being a horse. That's what they're designed to do. Some interaction, I believe, is wanted. Isn't that right? Are you ready to do your feet? Her feet have gone through some interesting changes. So if you guys remember, I think about last November maybe, I pulled her shoes off. So now she is a barefoot lady.
She's being so patient.
So her feet look superb. The front ones are slightly more misshapen, we like, but she's got hoof wall now, which is crazy. As long as I've known this horse, she's never had hoof wall. And now here we out here with all this hoof wall, double walled up on a Saturday. She needs to be done again because some of it is chipping a little bit. She has like an actual hoof wall. That's brazy, dog. Good girl. I don't know if you can see just how awesome this hoof looks. There's so much hoof wall. Do you guys remember that she's a thoroughbred? Like her, like obviously parts of it could be better. But it's so different. Who's that pretty mare? Come on, this away. Yep, your mom's over there. Come on. Go back to her and give her some peace of mind. Beautiful lady. Right? Come on, Goof. We're coming. Big winner chicken dinner. What do you think we should do? I have a few ideas. Somebody is impatient. Hold on. Sheesh. The boys are running as fast as possible in the background. Amber, can you go away? Here they come. Oh my God. Everybody's being crazy. Amber, go away. Good girl. Yes. And see, a few months ago when I did that, she was very not happy with me and was like biting the air and turning around and looking at me like I was crazy. That was very good, Zazu. She gets her snacks on the ground. Let her know we're done while I walk out of here. My runny nose. I'm very happy with that. For the first time in a long time, lead her out of her paddock and she walks quietly and is super calm and nice, and then do up the girth. Doesn't care. Isn't biting at me. And took care of me. Improvement in my books. So much for letting her know we're done. That's all, Lady Jane. That's all. Kitties. Okay guys, as far as I'm concerned, that is all for this video. I knew that I was gonna work with Zoe today and I kinda just wanted to film it, bring you guys along, do some updates, talk about where we're going from here. You know, really all I'm doing at the moment is just really focusing on school. Zoe and Amber running around. Anyway, I graduate with my undergrad in May, and then I'm gonna be gearing up for a master's program, but I'll have all summer to do pony things. And I'm really excited. I don't know, things are starting to feel like they're going back to normal, and I normally don't like to say that because I should always be moving forward, learning, changing, growing, evolving, but I felt very, very like below my normal average, and now we're getting like up again, and it feels so good to like want to work with horses again. And like, I'm gonna get so woo woo, but it feels so nice being able to like connect with them again, because there for a little bit it was like there was no connection. It was just like, I'm just doing this because I have to. And that is a topic that I want to discuss in a podcast, is what it's actually like making horses your job. So stay tuned for that. Jet Reel Podcast, available on Spotify, iTunes, Google Play, and many, many, many more places. Anyway, aside that spiel, it feels super nice to be able to connect again and feel like this is really my passion, you know? And I've missed it. I missed it a lot. I'm not saying that I'm coming back 110% to YouTube. I know that's not true. I don't have time nor really the willpower to do that. I do want to, you know, still do it whenever I feel like it, because I started this channel because it was something that I loved. Yeah, I don't know. I just felt like making a video today, sharing with you guys where we're at. And right now, that's like basically getting back in the swing of things. I want to be able to ride soonish. And so I'm just doing what I showed you guys today, bringing her out, getting her and her mama both used to her leaving for a little bit, and then putting her back in and getting her used to being in the cross ties, being groomed again and all that, and then slowly working on, you know, back in her paddock where it's her comfort zone, doing up a girth and like having something on her back again, like just slowly working up in baby steps with all of that. She's been crazy. I want to be able to work with her again. Oh, that was a big buck. Maybe not. I don't know. I just miss it a lot, and I'm rambling at this point. This is probably a really long video for you guys, but I hope that you enjoyed it and that you miss seeing Zoe's beautiful face and listening to me ramble for forever. Once again, if you want to hear that stuff, you can get on my podcast. Pretty great. I love it. Lots of positive reviews. You could always use some more listeners, because I like to eat and I cannot do that unless I make money. So yeah. All right. That is all. I'm going to sign off, you guys. Thank you so much for listening. You can check out the podcast, Jet Reel Podcast, or find us on Instagram, Jet Reel Podcast. Pretty active on jill.treese on my Instagram, my personal one. I've been using Jet Equitheory a little bit more, not really pressuring myself into a schedule on that one, just whenever I feel like talking about my pony. Those are all the things. Please check them out. Let me know how you guys are doing in the comments. It's been a hot minute. How's everybody? Is everybody feeling the winter blues, and we're finally getting back to like a day of sunshine, so like take advantage of it at all costs, because that's what I'm doing, because it's supposed to rain the rest of the week, which is gonna screw up my plans for getting my horse back together, but it's fine. Anyway, I'm gonna stop talking now. Have a good one, you guys. All my hard work, all my brushing, down the drain. I know what you're doing. At least it's a nice day for it. Bye.